Hello, dear friends. So, yeah, as if we didn't have enough problems already, it seems that they finally managed to get Iran involved in a direct attack to Israel. All we need now is something to happen in Taiwan, and we will have the full World War III they've been dreaming with. And yet, do you ever have the feeling sometimes that all these things are scripted? I know I do. It's just kind of odd the way things keep happening, always in the direction of this big war that nobody really asked for. Well, at least, no sane people. Then yesterday, exactly 5 years and one day after the Notre Dame burned and its spire fell, one of the oldest buildings in Copenhagen burned and its spire fell. Just coincidence? Perhaps. Or perhaps some kind of sign of the times to come? Something done on purpose? An occult ritual, perhaps? Another strange news of the week was the stabbing of a priest in Australia, just 2 days after another stabbing attack. Mari Emanuel was a popular priest from the Syrian Orthodox Church. He was in Gaza recently, where he made a very interesting speech.
I said, we pay you, you do as I say. Open the door. I want to say hello to this little girl. Palestinian, Muslim girl, my sweetheart. Yeah? I don't care. This is a little angel. Stop killing little angels.
So it's strange that he was attacked just after that visit. But he did tell both Jews and Muslims to turn to Christ, so there's that.
I pray they come both to the Lord Jesus. They will find their comfort, their peace at last.
Yet, according to the media, he was attacked because he was, wait for it, an anti-vaxxer. Well, that's great. I'm something of an anti-vaxxer myself, but I doubt the attack had anything to do with that. In any case, the propaganda is already out about the new axis of evil, which is Iran, Russia, and China. Never mind that China never really attacked anyone, and Russia and Iran, well, you may criticize them, but you can't exactly say that they weren't provoked. So, on one side you have this evil axis, and on the other side you have the Allies, or the so-called West. The calls for bringing back some type of military conscription in Western countries grows louder and louder. But what is the West today? These are some recent news from Canada, for instance.
Oh, Canada.
So, yeah, would you join the army to defend that? And you know, I'm not necessarily a great fan of Iran, China, or Russia and their more authoritarian systems, but, well, they look more or less like normal countries that want to maintain some of their tradition instead of going full crazy like the modern West. Anyway, so far, war with Iran seems to have been averted, and the war in Ukraine seems to be slowly dwindling down, never mind the usual requests for more money and more weapons. So perhaps we will be spared World War III? That would be great, because despite their triumphant discourse, I don't think the West is prepared.